Sydney Fields has a capacity of 75,000 metric tons per annum. And once the merger gets over, hopefully by the end of this year, Waterbase will have a capacity of 110,000 tons. So the brand name for this range of products would be Baylife. We will be introducing these products, basically probiotics, animal healthcare products, ammonia binders. Seasonal feeds is the order of the day today. State-of-the-art hatchery with an investment of around 20 crore rupees in Nellore with a capacity of say 500 million. The Thapar Group has a diversified portfolio. The group chose to enter into aquaculture. Now in 1993, aquaculture is still in a nascent form and it is not such a systematically organized sector. Why did you choose to do so? Basically, this project was conceived way back in 1980s. The man behind this project is our current chairman, Mr. Vikram Thapar. Mr. Vikram Thapar, when he was part of a business delegation, he went to Southeast Asia, South Asian countries, where he has seen how aquaculture has shaped those economies, how aquaculture has significantly contributed to the GDPs of those countries. So after coming back, he had this vision that India can play a very large role in the aquaculture business. Looking at our potential in terms of our long coastline, in terms of our tropical climatic conditions, he felt that India can become a major player in shrimp exports in the country. So he put up his proposal to the board of Thapar Group. Though initially he could not get good backing because the group as such was very highly diversified at that particular point of time. And this business of shrimp was, for a size of that group, I mean, this business was too small, so different from what they are doing. But somehow he could prevail upon board, and then this company was incorporated way back in 1987. And then process of building the company has begun. The company went public, one of the first companies in this field to go public. And probably those days, we were one of the first corporates to even think about aquaculture. The focus of Waterbase seems to be exclusively shrimp. There's not much fish involved in its portfolio, especially the feed segment. Why is that so? Our machinery is pelletized technology. So we did make fish feed, the sinking fish feed, at one particular point of time. But after that, with the robust growth in shrimp feed industry, we got stuck to shrimp feed. It's not that we cannot do fish feed. We can also do fish feed. We have those technologies. We have ample research done on fish feed. But right now, the focus is on shrimp feed. If your question is, will we be confined only to shrimp feed? I would say for the time being, yes, but we will not rule out entering into other feeds going forward.
Now, what is the current capacity of the feed mill that you have? And are you planning for any expansion?
Waterbase was initially set up to meet the captive consumption of our own farms. When we started our business way back in the early 90s, Waterbase was an integrated, probably the largest integrated aquaculture complex in Asia. We had shrimp farms, and to meet the shrimp feed demand, we have set up the feed mill. So the feed mill capacity was only 15,000 metric tons when it was conceptualized and implemented. But over a period of time, we have enhanced those capacities. And today, Waterbase feed mill capacity is about 35,000 metric tons per annum. Now, what we are doing right now is we are in the process of a merger with a company called Pine Feeds Limited. Pine Feeds Limited is a 100% subsidiary of our group, KCT Group, Karamchand Thapar Group. The merger process is on. Pine Feeds has a capacity of 75,000 metric tons per annum. And once the merger gets over, hopefully by the end of this year, Waterbase will have a capacity of 110,000 tons, metric tons per annum. I would say this capacity addition has came a bit late, but no better late than never. So yes, that will give us ample opportunities to go out in the marketplace, to go into new geographies, expand our dealer network, expand our farmer network, and then increase our market share in the market. Otherwise, we were stuck with 35,000 metric tons and we were unable to service our customers' requirements all these years. Now with enhanced capacities, we are now getting into new markets. We forayed into Gujarat in 2014. In 2015, we entered West Bengal. 2016, this year, we are entering into Odisha. So we could never venture into these markets with only water-based capacity. Now that we have access to higher capacities because of the merger, now we are foraying into new geographies.
And you have also ventured into another early entrant thing. You also ventured into retailing early on, a sort of an experiment, I believe. Do you have any plans to foray into retailing full scale now?
As you said, yes, it was an experiment that we did. I mean, we started the Tiger Bay chain of restaurants in Bangalore. That was an experiment those days to check whether we have a market and do we have the capabilities to do that. And we did that experiment, but we had to discontinue that. Probably because we were ahead of times those times. Can we come back to retailing? I mean, possibilities are there, but currently our priorities are different. Our focus is on the shrimp feed business, which is our main bread and butter. And we are again focusing on to exports, processing and exports, getting into hatcheries and looking at other possible value chains in the system.
If you look at other feed mills, many of the larger ones, they also have their sort of farm products like probiotics and others. Is Waterbase going to enter into that segment?
Yes, Waterbase is seriously considering to enter into this segment as well. Since we are giving technical service to farmers, most of the times we recommend probiotics and other animal healthcare products for the farmers. So what we decided this year is to enter into this segment under the brand name Bay Life. So the brand name for this range of products would be Bay Life. We will be introducing these products, basically probiotics, animal healthcare products, ammonia binders, vitamins, mineral premixes. So this range of products will be introduced mostly in the last quarter of this year.
Is there any other species that you're looking forward to? Vanamai is one. You came in early. Now there's another talk of blue shrimp. Now, are you also planning to venture into that area?
I think you know the fact that we are the first company to introduce Vanamai feed in the country. When the whole country was selling tiger feed, Waterbase was the first company to offer Vanamai feed in the market. We will never be late in introducing feed for any new species. We have the capabilities, we have the expertise, backed with 20 odd years of experience in research. So we will be the first to introduce new feed for any new species.
Now coming into the processing segment, you are an exporter of crabs, wild caught crabs. So do you see any potential for farming as an aquaculture culture for mud crabs?
Crabs we do in another company called Handy Waterbase India Limited. This is a joint venture company with an American company called Handy. Handy International is America's oldest seafood processor with more than 100 years of experience. So they joined hands with us, I mean with our group company. So Handy Waterbase India is our group company, which is focusing on pasteurized crab meat for the US market. Now, farming crabs in India is an interesting option that we will consider going forward. But right now, we get our crab from wild. And this is the blue swimming crab. We get it from the wild and then we process and export to US. Doing soft shell crabs or mud crabs, you know, is an interesting proposition. We definitely will look at those options, but right now our hands are full with so many projects underway.
What is the market potential for crabs in the US, an approximation?
I mean, I can't tell the number offhand, but crab eating is a very common thing in the US, and especially when they are offered a product like a shell-free crab, I mean, in different grades and different sizes, the Americans love it. You go to any restaurant in America or any supermarket, you know, the sales are picking up, the sales are growing. So we, along with our partner Handy, had been doing good business in US.
Can you just tell us about your R&D machinery that you have in place?
We have very good infrastructure available in our factory in Nellore, where we have plants, where we try out all the feed formulations before we actually send them to the marketplace. We have lab scale ponds. We also have grown out farms. So we have the requisite infrastructure at, and very recently we have introduced our new product Bay White Enriched in the marketplace to address the current problems the farmers are facing. So most of the problems come through the gut. So the gut has to be healthy. So we have devised a formulation which will strengthen the gut of the animal. So we have this feature, healthy gut, in our new feed formulation. So everything cannot be solved through feed. So whatever can be solved, we are attempting to do that. We also work with other leading companies of the world to carry out various trials. Now, fish meal is another important topic that the whole world is talking about, because it's getting scarcer every year. So how can we reduce the intake of fish meal into the formulation without foregoing the nutrition part of that? So we have done several experiments with leading companies in the world, and we have achieved good success in that as well. And that benefit goes to the whole industry. So Waterbase always looks at how to grow the industry rather than growing the company. So this has been our biggest contribution for the past 2.5 decades to the industry.
Thing was about specialty feeds, specific tailor-made feeds for different areas of the animal. Now that's a completely new area that people are venturing into, feed millers nowadays. Now, how do you see this progressing, given that the R&D backing is not a consolidated issue in India as of today, if you have a look at it?
Traditional feeds is the order of the day today. You cannot apply one solution for all problems. You have to look into different markets, different saline conditions, different temperatures. You know, you are working in a different environment every 200 kilometers. So how are you going to meet the challenges of the farmers who are growing their shrimps under a variety of conditions? So that's where we are trying to develop functional feeds to meet these requirements. Whatever can be solved through feed, we can solve through feed. Whatever cannot be solved through feed, then we look at solutions through animal healthcare products or through programs.
Now going into the future, in the next 3 years, where do you see Waterbase?
We're back in the 90s or late 80s. Our vision was to have an integrated aquaculture complex. We were 100% EOU. Now, over a period of time, we have witnessed how turbulent this industry was in the 90s. The widespread diseases those days, the issues related to pollution and the Supreme Court ruling, and the forex fluctuations, the anti-dumping duty wars. The industry has gone through ups and downs for the past 20 years. So during this 20-year period, we have moved away from a lot of other businesses. Like we stopped our farming, we stopped our hatchery business, we stopped our exports also. and we just focused on feed business. Now, we want to come back into all the businesses, not for the sake of increasing our revenues, but each of them has a complementary effect on the other business. For example, take the seed. Seed is very, very critical for the sustainable growth of this industry. 60% of your success in farming will depend on the seed. If the seed quality is not good, irrespective of how good your feed is, your animal will not grow. So the seed is very, very important, and unfortunately today, the quality of seed is under question. And not many organized companies are in this business. So we feel that it is our acute responsibility to give a good quality seed to the farmer, to our customers. So that's how we are venturing into hatchery business. We are setting up our first hatchery, state-of-the-art hatchery, with an investment of around 20 crore rupees in Nellore, with a capacity of say 500 million. And that would be the first hatchery. And going forward, we would like to set up many more hatcheries in different farming areas. The seed is very, very important. So we are getting into the seed business. Second, we are getting back into exports. We have a processing plant, but for some reasons, we have stopped our exports way back in 2007. Now we are restarting our exports. We have a capacity of 4,000 metric tons per annum. So we will scale up our capacity utilization each year. We don't want to rush. We'll gradually fill those capacities. So exports is another revenue stream that will kick in. As I said, we are going to launch the farm care range of products under the brand Baylife. So that would be another revenue stream. And going forward, we will explore if any other opportunities are available, you know, like getting into the domestic market, as you asked about retailing and all, and also getting into contract farming and other options that we will evaluate as we go along. But right now, these are the tasks that we have on hand. Mm-hmm.